This is a case that taught me some very important lessons. This was sent in by a colleague who's a good dermatopathologist. And this is from the, I can't remember the, was it nose? Papule on the nose of an 80-year-old man. And my colleague had done S100 protein or SOX10, one of those. CD34 was negative, S100 was negative, Desmond was negative, P40 was negative. So we've done the usual panel of markers you might consider for ruling out, you know, for looking at atypical fibrosanthoma versus melanoma versus spindle cell squamous cell carcinoma. But there's something about it didn't sit right with me. And I don't know if it was that it was kind of more epithelioid, almost nested a little bit. And I'm not used to seeing that in atypical fibrosanthoma. And I was like, I just don't feel right about this being atypical fibrosanthoma, despite the fact that all the stains have been negative. And then here's the clue, very subtle. So I'll show you the immunostains. This is ERG, E-R-G, diffusely positive. You can see it's not really quite so sheet-like as it looked. It's actually forming little nests and infiltrating in between the dermal collagen. Where's the other piece? Oh, is there, there's no other piece. Ah, there it is. And then here you can see maybe a little bit of vascular channel formation, but really each of the spaces is filled with cells. So very challenging. Here is CD31. Blazing. Very, very positive. And here you can see vessels lined by atypical CD31 positive cells. And now, CD34. Staining only the background vessels and completely negative in the tumor cells. And this is one of several cases I've seen of CD34 negative angiosarcoma. So I do not like CD34 as a vascular marker most of the time because of this. So no vascular marker is totally perfect, unfortunately. The difficulties, and I've got a little write-up on this if you can refer back to if you need to later. It's right here on the Kiko website. So this is kind of my, I'm not gonna read this all to you now, but my summary of how I kind of use vascular stains, okay? So ERG is very sensitive. I have not yet, knocking on wood, not yet seen an ERG negative vascular tumor. I'm sure I will eventually, but I've not encountered one yet. But it's not specific. ERG stains lots of things. It can stain prostate cancer, it stains epithelioid sarcoma, that new spindle cell thing, EWSR1 SMAD3, and sometimes AFX will have patchy staining, not diffuse strong, but kind of patchy, weak to moderate ERG staining. CD31 is very sensitive, but it is not quite as crisp and clean sometimes. It will stain histiocytes, usually with weak granular staining, but in a tumor that's very inflamed and has a high background histiocyte concentration, CD31 may not be the best choice because it will be dirty. It'll be hard to read. And what I want as my normal internal control when I'm looking at a vascular tumor, the tumor cells should be as strong as the background blood vessels and should be, if you have to ask, is this enough ERG? The answer is probably no. No, it's not. Like you should, when you have an angiosarcoma, you put down the ERG or the CD31 and you're like, whoa. You're not like, well, it's a little focal. No, let it go. That's nothing. It will be blazing. Knock your socks off, as we say in America, I think. I don't know. I don't know where all these sayings come from. Like that, right? Good enough to be the control tissue. All right. And then, so CD31, oh yeah, is is going to be is good, but it will be a little harder to read sometimes. Also, Kaposi sarcoma, to my surprise, sometimes is CD31 negative. And there's a really nice paper here that was written a few years ago about why that is. That human herpes virus 8 actually downregulates expression of the CD31 molecule, which I thought was really fascinating. I realized because I was trained in the era of HHV8 immunostaining, you know, we had HHV8 ever since I was a trainee. So if I wonder if something's Kaposi sarcoma, I don't do vascular markers, I just stain it for HHV8. And if it's positive, it's Kaposi sarcoma. Easy. But in the older days, like the 90s, there was not that. And back then, before anti-HIV therapy came around, and I thought this was a very poignant explanation that Omar Sangueza from Wake Forest, he's really interested in vascular tumors, and I interviewed him a few years ago for the American Society of Dermatopathology. I've done some interviews of really big-name, famous dermpaths, and they're all on the American Society of Dermatopathology YouTube channel. You should check them out, not because of me, but because these people I interviewed are just these legends, and they told these wonderful stories. I learned so much. But Omar said, and I loved it, he said, well, before, you know, in the early days of AIDS, there was no cure for AIDS, there was no treatment, and if you gave someone a diagnosis of Kaposi sarcoma, I mean, you were giving them AIDS, basically. And I just, that was kind of a really eye-opening moment of how significant and scary that time was, and that it became very important to separate out Kaposi sarcoma from mimics, because it meant something very bad at the time. Whereas now it's more of a chronically managed disease outside of the setting of AIDS, not curable, but usually not something that's going to kill patients. In this setting, there are some exceptions in, you know, patients with immunosuppression or African endemic type, which can be more aggressive sometimes. But in any case, the point was, is I didn't realize that, and I thought that was an interesting article if you're curious. And CD34 can sometimes be a nice stain for vascular tumors, but recognize that it can be negative. So in difficult cases, sometimes I'll use all three of those markers, but I recommend not using CD34 as your only screening marker for vascular tumors. It is dangerous because I've seen cases like this. An angiosarcoma is an aggressive tumor. Sometimes it's treated in unique ways, different from other tumors and other types of sarcomas. It has some very unique things about it that needs to make sure that it's not missed. Okay?